Hello, I'm Jack Parry-Jones, and I play Brian in A Kind of Kidnapping. So Brian and Maggie are down on their luck. She is a failed actress, and I am a taxi driver, and also taking a computer course to do what? I can't actually remember, but I'm taking a computer course. And because they're so down on their luck, they decide to kidnap a Tory politician. I think he's a Tory. I don't think he's ever mentioned that he's a Tory, but I'm saying he's a Tory. we hold him for ransom. And then all sorts of stuff goes wrong, as it's bound to.
And what was it about that setup, that idea, that excited you as a storyteller the most?
So I got sent through the script and I did my tape for it. But I just thought that, to be honest, it was Dan's writing. It was so sort of fluid and really, really easy to get on board with. I think that was the thing that really excited me, was just that opportunity to speak those words, and also to act with people like Kelly and Patrick was an absolute dream. So, you know, that was probably it.
Can you tell us a little bit more about what that experience was like working with Kelly and Patrick?
It was manic because, you know, Patrick is... Patrick's an absolute lad, but no, they were fantastic, really just on top of everything. And I feel that actually watching them, there's always this thing that you're watching other actors and you want to learn off them, and I do feel that I was learning bits off of them. Just, you know, Patrick is so consistent, and Kelly's just got such great energy from take to take that it's really brilliant.
We're living at a time where people's confidence and trust in politicians has never been at a lower ebb. Do you think that this is a particularly apropos moment for a story like this?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, we're living in a cost of living crisis, and our politicians don't really seem to care. I say seem, but, like, you know, if you can show me any evidence that they do, I'd be happy to look at it. But it feels like, you know, rent is going up, and, you know, landlords don't care. They are putting it up to be in line with inflation, not because anything has changed about their property. And I think that it's such a tough time for people. And I think that that's why this story will really resonate with people, is just because it is such a tough time, and these characters are kind of doing the thing that I think we all cheekily would like to do, but I don't think that it's the best idea. Just to put it out there, it's not the best idea to kidnap politicians.
Definitely not. Talking about difficult times, obviously for the creative industries, it's a particularly sensitive time. And obviously today we have the news of the likely SAG strike joining the Writers Union in America. I'm curious how you feel about that and the pressures that both in this country and overseas we are seeing on our creative industries.
It is tough. And I hear off of... I was chatting to someone who did the makeup on this, Vanessa, and she was saying that, like, you know, it is such a tough time because people are... It's just a tough time. I don't really know how to put it into any other words. It's just a tough time.
And in terms of other great stuff you've got coming up and that we're enjoying at the moment, I think, hi Jack, I think we're very much enjoying that at the moment. Can you just tell us very quickly a little bit about what it was like to work with the icon that is Mr. Idris Elba, and what can you expect from the rest of that series as we get to enjoy those final episodes?
Do you know what? It was, you sign on to it because you go like, oh my God, it's filming on a plane. That sounds awesome. And then you spend 6 months on a plane, and you're just in this too. But it was like, it was really cool to work with that cast. It was really awesome to see everyone's work, and now to actually get to see other parts of the plane as well. Idris has got such presence on set, and such, like, you know, it was fascinating to watch him work. It was really cool.
And I mean, obviously fans have been enjoying the episode so far. Was there a particular highlight for you, a particular sequence or scene that you most enjoyed getting a chance to bring to life?
There might be some stuff coming up that I can't tell you about. You know, you'll have to watch it. If you're excited by it, continue to be excited by it. That's about it.